Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I have a review video for you about some Korean sheet masks. I know I already did a Korean sheet mask video a while ago, but it was about different brands, like multiple different brands in one video. And this time it's actually all one brand, it's Jinju, which they actually sell at a Dutch drugstore now, so I'm assuming they probably might sell them at more drugstores. Which is very convenient because, you know, Korean sheet masks are usually cheaper than non-Korean sheet masks. But they're sort of difficult to get. Well, not really difficult to get, but it's just if you order them at eBay or BeautyNet Korea or stuff like that, it takes quite some time for them to arrive. It's just easier to go to a store and physically buy them and immediately have them. So yeah, I picked three different ones. I always have to think of how many fingers to put up. Point is, three different ones, which I tried out in the last 3 weeks. I tried to do them once per week just because, I don't know, like I feel like it's not really necessary for my skin to do them more often. I don't want to waste them. I really do want to enjoy them. So I did them once per week. And yeah, I think the best way to just review them is by putting them on and immediately telling you how I like them. So let's get started. First mask I want to try is the Jinju Beauty Egg White Sheet Mask. This is supposed to give extra glow. That's literally all it says. Korean Super Beauty Extra Glow, and that's it. On the back, it actually does have directions in English as well, in multiple languages, including Korean. But unlike some of the stuff that I bought at BeautyNet Korea a while ago, it does actually have, you know, it in English as well, which is rather nice for those of us who can't read Korean, like me. Like, really, like, I can't, I have no idea what that says, but the English version I can actually read. However, on the back it only says that you gotta be careful, you know, like, in the very event of an adverse reaction, discontinue use for external use only, like that sort of stuff. Like, that's important, but unfortunately it doesn't say exactly what this mask is supposed to do. Like, extra glow, is it supposed to make you more oily? I hope not, because I have oily skin. Or is it supposed to bleach your skin? Or is it, well, whiten the skin? Is it supposed to, like, I don't know, whatever, make your skin more clear? I have no idea, so we'll see. Yeah, it does actually say on the back how you're supposed to use it in pictures. So you're supposed to clean your face first. I'm filming it at the end of the day. Then you're supposed to apply it, obviously. Then you're supposed to wait for 10 to 20 minutes. Peel it off, then rub in the excess oil or whatever on your face. And that's it. So yeah, also by the way, I'll take a picture of the ingredient list. So if you actually want to know what ingredients are in there, you can just ask me and I'll look it up for you. We're just going to continue using it. Yeah. No scissors needed. By the way, I'm going to keep the little packaging because you can actually use the residue inside it as a nighttime moisturizer as well. So the mask feels nice and sturdy. It's sort of thick, it's not too thin. Yeah, it's like very nicely like wet, moist, damp, whatever you want to call it, with the mask, so that's good. So yeah, let's put it on. One downside of masks like these is, of course, that no one's face is the same. So for me, the mouth is usually a little bit too low, this part is a little bit too thick. My nose is bigger than the mask, my eyes also don't quite completely fit, and my forehead is too big for the mask as well. However, overall it does sit nicely. It does cover most of my face, especially if I apply it correctly. And it is damp enough to actually stay in place, so yeah, I'm just going to leave it on for 20 minutes and then get back to you. So, the mask has been on for about 20 minutes now. It does feel slightly more, well, not really dry, but less damp, so it did sink into my skin, which is good. Also, it at no point felt uncomfortable, like it felt sort of tingly when I just put it on, but mostly just, like, refreshing, really. So yeah, let's take it off now. So I'm just rubbing it into my skin now, like the packaging tracks. There is quite a bit left on my neck, on my face. I'm also dragging it down my neck, was what I was trying to say. I often just combine things in my head. Point is, but considering how very damp the mask was, it's not very surprising that there is residue. But now that I'm rubbing it, it does actually sink into my skin very, very quickly, so that's good. It's pretty much sunken in now, and I gotta say, like, well, Me personally, I have oily skin, so I prefer to do a face mask in the evening. Just because if I very much nourish my skin, like I do nourish my skin and moisturize it every single morning, because otherwise it just starts to overcompensate and go more oily. However, I don't try to overdo it because I try not to overdo it. Just because then it gets very, very oily, which isn't what I go for usually. But using a mask like this in the evening doesn't mean that you don't have to use a nighttime moisturizer afterwards, which is very, very nice and handy and just saves time. I do actually think it does give a very nice glow. Like, it didn't enlarge my pores or anything, but it makes my skin look very, very glowy without making it oily as well. Like, I hope you can really tell on camera. Like, I have bright lights on me right now, so you could probably tell. I really, really like it. I do also think that this might be really good for, like, dry skin if you don't naturally have a lot of glowiness. That's really, really good. But even on my oily skin, well, combination to oily skin, it's just very, very nice. Like, yeah, I will probably still even use this below makeup because it really doesn't feel oily in any way. It just feels, you know, very nourished, soft, and just, yeah, it looks very nice and glowy. The mask I'm showing you now is the Bubble Bobble Sheet Mask. It's so exfoliating. It looks absolutely adorable with a little pink beer on it. Also, by the way, I'm wearing black contact lenses because I just filmed a special effects tutorial and, yeah, I figured a cleansing mask would be suitable after that. I do notice with this mask is while I'm talking, it does sag down probably because of the bubbles in it, so I do need to drag it up every now and then. As you can see, the mask itself, by the way, is black and then it just creates this white foam out of nowhere, which I don't want in my mouth. It smells clean, very clean, like sort of like lemonade slightly. The way you're supposed to use this is by rubbing it between your hands for 5 seconds. I think that is sort of activates the foaming quality. Then wash your face. I switched this to around because I'd already washed my face before I even grabbed the mask. Put it on, leave it on for 10 to 15 minutes, then take it off and rub in the excess. So yeah, that's what I'm going to do now and then I'll get back to you. Okay, I'm just coming back here real quick in between, waiting for the mask to do its thing. You do need to pull it up every now and then because it does sag down. And as you can see, it keeps developing bubbles. I have to talk really carefully because of that. But yeah, it keeps developing bubbles, and once you're quiet and not talking while wearing this mask, you do feel the bubbles actually popping softly against your skin, so it is a very nice and relaxing mask. Okay, as you can see, the part that I pulled up her face just now is relatively clean. The other part looks like something a serial killer would wear. Still feels bubbly on my skin right now. As you can see, there's still bubbles all over it, so I'll just rub them in as the packaging suggests. So when rubbing it in, I do feel like it turns into some sort of moisturizing cream. Like, it doesn't feel like a gimmick. It doesn't feel like something that's just foamy and nothing else. It does actually feel like something that has, you know, stuff in it. Now that it's fully rubbed in, I do feel like I'm wearing a very thick night cream. Admittedly, I would actually use this mask in the night rather than in the evening. In the evening or night rather than in the morning. Yeah, that was what I was trying to say. Just because for my skin, I feel like if I would put makeup over top of it now, it would just go very oily. Or at least, it doesn't feel oily, but you know, shiny, too shiny. I have oily skin, so I try to steer away from shininess most of the time. It does feel very nice and moisturized, which I'm actually surprised about because it's supposed to be exfoliating. Admittedly, in my skin does feel very fresh and clean and nice. My pores are completely clean and, you know, in case you've seen last week's SFX tutorial, you can probably imagine how my pores looked afterwards. Like, they were full of eyeshadow, purple eyeshadow to be precise, mostly. I'm actually quite pleased with how this turned out. Like, my skin looks clean, but not, it doesn't feel squeaky clean. It's just very nice. There's a perfect balance between clean and still nourished. And the mask does actually give the result that I really love about sheet masks. That I don't have to bother using a moisturizer afterwards. Like, I just rubbed it in and I just feel like I've applied night cream and eye cream and lip balm all at the same time. And it feels just perfectly fine now. All in all, I really, really like this mask and it's definitely one that I'll repurchase. And then we have this mask, which is the Avocado Sheet Mask Super Moisture. I gotta admit, I don't even remember what the first mask was called or what it was supposed to do. I used that one like 2 weeks ago at this point when I'm filming this. But anyway, yeah, I think it was like super hydrating, but this one is super moisture. And there is a very cute, although not completely anatomically correct, picture of a frog on it. Holding a sliced through avocado in his paws. So yeah, it looks absolutely adorable, like a lot of Korean skincare does. And just like the other masks, it doesn't state anything on, you know, like what exactly it is supposed to do. It's just supposed to be moisturizing, and other than that, that's it. And like the other masks, it states how to use it, as in wash your face, apply the mask, wait for 10 to 20 minutes, take it off, rub in the excess, and that's it. So yeah, let's give this a go. Just like the first mask, it's nice and moisturized when you get it out of the packaging, which is good. Okay, you know those, like those dessert things specifically for kids by Danone? I don't quite remember which particular one, but the yellow one, I think it was vanilla. It vaguely smells like that, which is not a bad thing, it's just sort of weird considering this is avocado and not vanilla. But yeah, it's an interesting scent for skincare. Okay, just like the other masks, this one doesn't seem to quite fit on my face properly. But then again, it's wet enough that I can easily spread out the moisture to still get every part of my face. So yeah, other than that, it's sticking to my face, just, you know, like it should, it's not uncomfortable. So yeah, I'm just going to leave it there for about 20 minutes and then I'll be back. So the mask has been on here for like 30 minutes because I was editing a video and I completely forgot about it. So yeah, time to take it off. I don't actually think it's a bad thing to leave it on for longer, because now the actual sheet is a lot more dry than it usually is. Yeah, there is a lot of residue on my face, so I'm just going to massage it in like the packaging suggests. My skin does seem to absorb this well, so yeah, it seems to be pleased with it. I do feel like it's... I just remembered, by the way, what the first mask was. It was glowy, and this is more glowy than the glowy mask. So me personally, I would rather use this in the evening like I'm doing now than in the morning before doing makeup, because I have oily skin and glowy tends to go disco ball on me pretty quickly. However, yeah, I do actually like this result. My skin feels very nice, very moisturized. It does look a little bit oily, or at least a little bit more shiny than I would necessarily like. However, it's not at a uncomfortable level. It's more like a night cream. So yeah, that's actually just perfect for in the evening. So yeah, all in all, I'm happy with it. And that brings us to the end of this review video. Yeah, now 3 weeks later, my skin is very pleased and I need to go buy more sheet masks because I'm out of sheet masks now. But anyway, yeah, I really hope this review was useful to some of you, or at least fun to watch. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want to, you can also subscribe to my channel. I do mostly makeup tutorials. I've also done a tutorial on this look, which I'll link somewhere up here. And yeah, I also do review videos, obviously, nail art and whatever else I can think of. Piercing videos as well, by the way. But yeah, anyways, also below the video, I'll put a list of the 3 sheet masks I used today. Just in case you want to purchase them as well, it's probably easier to just be able to read the name. And also you can find the full list of all my social media accounts and names there. I'd especially like it if you'd want to follow me on Instagram, because I also always post it there whenever I upload a new video on YouTube. Obviously sharing pictures of it. Thank you very much for watching this video. And yeah, I hope you have a wonderful day. And I hope to see you next time. Bye!